CSIRO is Australia's National Science Research and Development Agency. We investigate everything from the oceans to fish, coal, wheat crops, and even how to make the best ice cream. I'm Susan Wijffels, and I'm an oceanographer at the CSIRO. There are lots of different types of oceanographers. I'm trying to understand how the oceans move around the world. So I study big, powerful currents like the East Australia Current. So the thing I like about my job is I get to figure out how the oceans work, why some parts are hot and others are cold, why some parts are salty and others are fresh. I do research on the Southern Surveyor. This is the Marine National Facility, and that means any Australian scientist can ask to use it for research, and CSIRO takes care of it. The ship is capable of dredging up rocks from the seafloor kilometres down, and this helps us to learn about the history of the planet. Other scientists use the ship to collect fish samples from the deep, dark waters at the bottom of the ocean. I go out on the ship to put in some of the most advanced equipment on the Earth. This float is actually a clever robot. When we pop it over the side in the ocean, it will dive to 1 kilometre, drift for a while, and then dive to 2 kilometres depth, and then start measuring things all the way up to the surface. Once it's popped up to the surface, it will send all of its data back to me at my desk via satellites. It's very clever, and it can do this for 8 years. Another way I do research in the deep ocean is by putting a giant float out in the middle of the ocean, which has a lot of neat sensors in it. And to make sure it doesn't float away, we tie it to heavy things like old train wheels or massive blocks of concrete. And we leave it there for 18 months, and then we go back and pick it up. Then my team and I can look at the information it's been collecting, like how fast the currents are moving and what temperature the seawater was and how salty it's been. The other piece of equipment I use looks a bit like a scuba diving tank strapped to a drum. The cylinders actually collect lots of water from really deep in the ocean, where it is impossible for people to go. By having a lot of data collected in different ways, so with the robots, the floats, and the cylinders, we can understand more about our oceans. That's important because our oceans make our rain and oxygen, and ultimately they make our world livable. We rely on computers to run our sensors and help us look at our data. This is the ops room, and you can see there are lots of computers. I use these computers to analyse the water samples and all of the data that the ship has collected. And then we can make a map to show where the currents have travelled. And then there's the hard bit. We need to then work out why. On top of the ship, there's a lot of communications equipment. And this allows me to send the data that we collect on the Southern Surveyor to my colleagues in Australia and all around the world. And it also allows me to keep in touch with my family. I love how mysterious the ocean is. We know so little about it, and yet it makes up 2/3 of our planet. The work I do with my team aboard the Southern Surveyor is helping us to better understand what's happening in the deep oceans.